I haven't prepared anything, but I feel like I need to say things. I have a lot to say. I don't like this feeling. Today, and no, let's just start from the beginning. Everything sucks right now. I've spent no. I started back at school last year. At this time last year, transferred into a new school with my associate's degree. 33 credits transferred. I need 120 to get my bachelor's degree. So, where I stand with it is that I have a lot of work to do. I can't stop working because I have bills, debts, I'm an adult. I haven't really maintained my life properly as I should. So, I have expectations. I haven't really cared because I work hard, I have a good job, I enjoy my job well enough. At least I did in the past. But let's kind of put it back to where I am now. Over the last year, being back in school, I've kind of rebounded and started hating my job as much as when the job was actually legitimately bad and I was considering quitting. Now, this time around, it's simply me. I'm not enjoying the job. I'm not doing good at the job as I once did. I don't enjoy it at all. It's a desktop support job, not a desktop support job, it's a software support job. I do software support for in-house developed software for hospitals. And we do lots of really interesting things. From the IT perspective, I should be in heaven. But I don't know, I'm just not enjoying it. The software's quality control has gone to hell. We're constantly cleaning up and covering up mistakes. And I feel more like a janitor these days than someone who's there to train users and make sure everything runs smoothly for them. I hate it. I hate it so much. And I can't quit because it's a job that is 2 blocks away from my school. So I can coordinate my schedule with work, go straight to school for the evening, and everything's fine. I know I don't have to learn things at work, so I could focus my efforts on learning things at school. But then there's school itself. Most of my classes have entailed things I've already known, and it's just a ton of work to do things I have no passion for. I don't want to do these things. I don't want the degree. I don't want any of that. So the question would be, why are you doing any of this? If you don't want school, then quit school, quit your job, find a better job, get everything squared away. Take hold of your life, Tim. But it's more complicated than that. In 2007, I was dating a girl. Sabrina, she was everything to me, and it only made sense that she would continue to be. I graduated from my associate's degree program in 2005, and I knew that, I was just going to be with her forever. I don't see why that would ever fail. Everything's been perfect. So I continued about. 2 years of just maintaining that relationship and not really having any luck in my professional life. Near the end of that relationship, going into the spring, I was talking with Sabrina about going back to school, getting a bachelor's degree, getting into education. partly because when I was in high school, I had made the joke that I wanted my high school programming teacher's job because she couldn't do it well. I was teaching her class for her. And I think at that point in 2007, it made sense that, hey, I should get my degree, go back to school, be a teacher, and do that thing. I should have done that. I had visited the school. I had met with the president of the nearby college to the town I lived in, back home. I was still living with my parents. I met with the president of that school, who asked me what education I already had. And when I told him I had my associates, he extended his hand, shook it, and welcome to Cal. And I don't know, that's cool. So it was kind of decided in my heart. I was going back to school. Yeah. I was working at Wendy's. I didn't have a professional career yet. I had worked for a small ISP for 6 months, and it was the worst job I've ever had, by far. I never want to think about that time again. But, yeah, mid-2007, I'm going back to school. May, I want to say 17th, 2007. That day's probably not right, but I guess that's neither here nor there. Yeah, that is the day that I received a call from Sabrina, and she broke up with me over the phone. We had been engaged for 5 months. So, I was derailed. My whole life was derailed. I didn't react well. So, any thought that there was going to be that I was going to go back to school immediately sunk. It just wasn't going to happen. So instead, I doubled down on working hard and getting out of Wendy's, which worked out in the end. My very, very kind friend got me a job at a small consulting business to the north of the city. I worked there for a month before I moved to the city. Well, to the north of the city. With the same friend. I moved in with him. And that was fun. It went well. In the end, I hated that job. Started to consider how cool it would be that if I did get that degree, I could move to Japan. Teach English, because that's kind of a thing that's possible. People do it. It would be really fun. I don't have anything tying me down. 2007 approaches its end. September, I meet a girl. We date. I continue my career. That job was awful. The job was good, but the conditions were bad. I quit that job once I had gotten hooked up with a recruiter who would find me better. And he did. 3 weeks later, I was working in a new position. This was the end of 2010. And that job has kept me until now. But I focused so much on my career and getting my life together that I never thought to go back to school. That second relationship continued on strong, strong. And again, I deluded myself to believe that that was never going to end. Fast forward 2015, February 16th, it ended. that relationship ended bad for me. She ended up all right. But I don't want to get into those details. So I spent the entirety of 2015 rebuilding myself. I had been gaining weight, so I hit the gym really hard. That entire year, all I did was diet and go to the gym. I was going good. I was doing really good. Then I got comfortable. I accepted that this is my new life. This is how it's going to be. 2016 rolls around. I decided that it's time to actually go back to school. In my yearly review, I tell my direct report manager that I didn't want to do the job anymore. I was going to, but I didn't want to. Started looking, getting a new job at a university. I didn't end up doing that, but I did get accepted into a school two blocks away from where I worked, and still do. 33 credits, a pretty good grant for being a transfer student. Yeah, I'll take it. That's fine. Chart the course out. Yeah, you're going to graduate spring 2019. And that seemed like a perfect plan. It was great. It was wonderful. It was great. 12 credits a semester? Oh, yeah, that's fine. I got this. No question. No problems. So thus enters my fall semester 2016. I have a world religions class, a ancient civilizations class, well, European civilizations class, a database class, and a networking class. My associate's degree is in computer network management. I was taking a networking 101 class, which was technically a 160, but it was a beginner's class. I could have taught that. I could have taught the database class. I'm a damn idiot. So that 4 months was the longest 4 months of my life. It felt like 7 years. I didn't want to do it. By the end of it, I was unfocused. I felt like I'd lost my mind. I moved on. The spring semester went much better. I had an English 101 class. I had a programming class, intro to programming, but I hadn't programmed very heavily since 10 years ago, so that's fine. I had a business 101 class online. And I got through these four classes, and the spring went better. I felt like I was accustomed. I was doing good. I took the summer off because financially my loans couldn't cover any more classes for the year, and I figured it would be good to take a load off. But now here we are. It's September 2017. My fall semester has begun again. I have four more classes, one of them online. My online class is 8 weeks. The teacher says she estimates between 19 and 22 hours of hard study per week, which would mean that all of my free time would be dedicated purely to that class, excluding other classwork and even not focusing at my actual work. So that's fun, and that would be fine. But let's get into, I'm pretty stressed over it because, I went to buy the book through the publisher's website and I have neither access to the book nor access to my assignments on the website that they insist us use. I've got nothing. So I ordered another one of my books from Amazon, which won't arrive for another week and a half, so can't do my work on there until then. And the other two classes are It's going to be hard. This is the hardest programming course in the entire... Well, this is the hardest programming class in the course. As everyone in the course has agreed, both previous students and professors alike. So that's unfortunate. Yesterday, I kind of wasted the day. Drove about 3 hours out with a buddy to have early dinner. Came home. Wasted the evening. Today, I woke up. All my friends were playing D&D in a campaign that I can't join because I have schoolwork so much. I know I would be wasting their time and my own. So, most of my friends were there. The rest of them were in Ohio or out with events, doing things with people. And for the last 2 weeks, my family has made plans and had fun times and didn't even tell me. One time they were downtown, which is 5 minutes from my house. And that was last weekend. And this weekend they had a cookout for Labor Day, a day early, because my mom works on actual Labor Day. And well, I wasn't invited to that, so I didn't get to have fun today. Instead, I went and had early dinner alone at a restaurant that most people wouldn't bother going to. And then I came home and did nothing. I've wasted my day completely. I called home, found out that they were having that cookout, and I told my dad that he didn't tell me about it. He said, well, you can come down anytime you'd like. It just kind of happened. We didn't really plan it. I understand. That's fine. Guess that's just how it goes. My mom tried to convince me to scale back my classes because I'm stressed out. It's not really the work that's stressing me out. It's the scale of things. And it's where my heart sits right now. My social life and my well-being are on hold until I can finish school. I can't date somebody because my plan is to leave the country in 3 years. Oh yeah, sorry, dating you has been wonderful, but I'm out. See you never. No, I'm not going to do that. I could scale back the number of classes, but it wouldn't change stress. It would just make me stress more because I wouldn't graduate until 2020, 2021. It would be a long way off, and I can't deal with that. I can't handle that. I need to get through school as quickly as I possibly can, as quickly as I reasonably can. I really want to move to Japan. I don't know why. I can't explain why. It's just the adventure of it. It seems like a great place. I forget who it was, but somebody said you can't really fix problems by changing geography and changing where you are, and I totally agree with that. But I've held my life here because I know all this work is going to be worth it, and I'm starting to question whether it's going to be worth it. I don't know if it's going to be worth it. Right now, the way it seems, 31 years old. When I originally went back to school, I thought it would be 2.5 years of classes, just straight, then I get my degree. Now it's looking more like 3.5. I'll be 35 before I even get the chance to go back. Before I even get the chance to move. 35-year-old man changing countries. 10 years ago, I would have said it would have been impossible to go back to school at the age of 31. I have friends who say I'm strong for even making the choice to go back to school. It's not in them, they say. It's not in me either. I'm not anything special. I've got nothing to bring to the table. I don't know why I'm recording this video, or why I'm going to upload this video. I don't think anybody's going to listen. I think anybody's going to care. But I needed to record and establish how I feel in this moment, so that if something happens to me, maybe someone will understand what I was going through. And if nothing happens to me, which is much more likely, and I get through all this, and I win in the end, I can watch this video in 4 years and say, that's what it was like. I remember feeling like that. And I can trivialize it, and I can say, yeah, it wasn't really that hard, Tim. You're just weak. In the year 2020, Tim Strickler, don't be that guy. Remember where you're from. Remember how hard this was. Remember every day laying in bed, just hoping you don't wake up. Because it's hard. It really is hard. To anyone who follows this channel expecting other things, I'm sorry. All I've given you is a 20-some minute long rant with a bit of history in it. Maybe it'll give you some insight. Maybe it won't. Maybe you already know my story. Maybe you don't. But I appreciate you hearing me out. And I hope whoever you are, things are going better for you than they are for me. Cheers.